Hello friends, my name is Shivam from DevOps Schools and I will help you to enable your learning process in various technologies of DevOps, artificial intelligence, machine learning, big data and many more. This is our initiative to help you by sharing multiple tutorials and videos. And if you want any specific tutorials on any particular topic, then please do comment in the below comment section and I will help you with it. Also, please subscribe to our premium services on YouTube, which will give you access to more content and videos to enhance your knowledge about all these topics. Also, if you want me to help you with regards to the online trainings and classroom sessions by our qualified trainers, then please write me at contact@devopschool.com. Thank you.
Okay, so I can just write xtrain is equal to xtrain dot reshape. Okay, xtrain dot reshape. Okay, and then I can say xtrain dot shape of zero. What is shape of zero? Nothing but okay. So what is shape of zero? Nothing but 60,000 actually, right? So similarly, I can write xtrain dot shape of one, then xtrain the shape of two, and then comma one. We are just adding this, that's it. Okay, similarly I can just change it for xtest dot reshape of xtest dot shape of zero, and then x underscore test dot shape of one, and x underscore test dot shape of two, and then comma one. So now if I print the shape, now you can see something like this: 60,000 by 28 by 28 by 1, 10,000 28 by 28 by 1. Now the input shape is just this. This is the length of the records. There is a number of records actually. Okay, so we have to consider the input shape, that is each and every input. Okay, this is the number of records. The first one is nothing but what? Number of records. So each and every input is of size 28 by 28 by 1. So now what we can do is, I can say input shape is equal to, I can say xtrain dot shape of 1 colon, right? So now you can see input shape will be like this, 28 comma 28 comma 1. And then now I am going to determine the output classes, determine the number of output classes.
Oh, no, I didn't understand why we reshaped. Is it that we converting to that columnar vector or?
No. Columnar vector, it will be converted implicitly using flattened layer.
Flattened. Okay.
See, now if you just give something like this, right? Whenever you send, it should be in three dimensions like this. Okay, 28 by 28 by 1. So this one indicates
for every
the
node.
Channel. Yes, for every node. Okay, this one indicates a channel basically. Okay, channel means it indicates a nature of the color. Okay, for RGB, it is 3, for grayscale, it is 1, like that. Okay, so for that, what we are doing is over here, we are just adding one basically over here, that's it.
Okay.
So and then this is the input shape. Now see here, if you see the image, you can see 28 by 28 by 1. So now you are getting that input shape, right? 28 by 28 by 1. Okay, got it. That's getting it.
No, I don't understand. How it changed the shape to that? So that you mean that input 2 got represented
convolution
in this?
Should be like this. Yeah, the input to convolution should be in this particular form. That is 28 by 28 by 1. That's why we are adding 1 to it actually. See, what is xtrain of shape actually? Let me just say it over here itself. Okay, one second. Okay, so what is x to n dot shape? It is 60,028,28. Correct. So now we need to change it to 60,028,28,1. We have to add it. Okay, we have to add it. So now the it was in this particular thing, right? Okay, now if I just print this one, right? Okay, let's say print x trine of 0. Now you can see that we just print only one particular element. Okay, let's say 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let me just print that 5. Okay, of 5. Now you can see it is in this particular spot. Okay, all right. So now we are converting each and every row, okay, into columns basically. That is, I am just adding one particular shape over here. Okay, so now after executing this, okay, I will be getting something, the data like this. Like this actually. Got it? That is, each and every array will be in this particular form now. Clear, guys?
Yeah.
Okay, we are sending in this particular form. Okay, so it was in this particular form, like if you just get one particular width, but flatten is different. The columnar vector is completely different. That is, you will convert the entire record into in this particular form. That is different actually. Okay.
So over here, on that line 22 says that is what it is, the one some number it they have represented in this particular format, right?
Mm-hmm. That is one part of that particular number.
Okay.
Okay. It's not the complete data. That is, whenever you say x prime of 0, that is nothing but 5. Okay, huh. Whenever you say x prime of 0 of 5, that means some part in this particular number,
okay,
not
okay.
The entire number.
Okay, okay, yeah.
Got it, right? Everyone clear with that? It is just one pixel in this particular number. That's it. What about other two?
Yes, that's
fine. Yeah, Mohan, got it.
Yeah, okay. So now what we are going to do, that is, we need to pass this particular shape while passing the input to conversion layer. So that's why we are retrieving only this particular part, because this 60,000 is number of records. And each and every record in this particular form, like 28 rows, that is, width is 28, height is 28, and each and every will be in this particular form. Okay. So, and then we are finding the number of output classes. From where I can find output classes, I can just say np.unique of y underscore train. See here. This is nothing but output classes. Okay, it's nothing but output classes. So it is like either 0 to 9. So whenever I give some image, okay, that has to be decided either 0 to 9. Okay, then I can just write number of output classes. Let's say number of classes is equal to len of this. So now if I print number of classes, it will be 10. This is nothing but number of labels actually. Okay, number of output labels. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm going to normalize the pixel values. That is, if you see these pixel values, the value ranges from 0 to 255, right? Now, I am going to normalize this particular value. In order to, it should be between 0 and 1. Okay, that is, each and every pixel should be between 0 and 1. That's it. Okay, so for that, what we can do is I can just write x trine is equal to x trine dot as type of float 32 divided by 255.0, and then x test is equal to x test dot as type of float 32 divided by 255.0. Okay, so now if I print this particular data, okay, only one particular pixel, okay, now you can see the output like that is each and every value is between just 0 and 1. That's it. Maximum it will be 1. That's it. Because here it will be 255. Okay, each and every value of x trine will be 0 and 1. So guys, clear so far? Yeah? Okay. So now what we are going to do, we are going to define the model. Okay, we are going to build the model now. That is, first we have to define model is equal to sequential. Okay, and then we need to add layer by layer. First we are going to add the layer, convolution layer. Okay, so let me just write add convolution layer. Okay, model dot add convoluted 2D. Okay, and then I can just write. Okay, so what will be the output from this particular layer? And then how many matrix will be considered? Like we just considered 2x2 matrix, right? For each and every data type. So similarly, how many what is the size of the matrix needs to be considered, and what is the activation function should be used in order to normalize the output?
And size then, of the matrix means the window.
Yes, the particular okay. Window size should be okay. Okay, and then how the weights should be calculated. Kernel initializer should be HE uniform, that is random uniform. And then what is the input shape? Input shape is equal to input shape, because we have in one variable, right? See here, input shape is 28, 28, 1. Okay, that is nothing but convolution layer. And then next one is pooling layer. That is model dot add, okay, max pool. Okay, max pool, and what size needs to be considered? That is, we should consider 2x2 matrix, and in that I have to select max value. Okay, this is nothing but pooling layer. Then I am going to do flatten. That is model dot add of flatten. So here it will do reshape, that is columnized vector. Then I am going to have hidden layer. Okay, then I'm going to have hidden layer. That is model dot add of dense. So dense will be used for hidden layers. Okay, then I can give 100. Then activation is equal to ReLU. See, this value you can give anything. There is no limit. And you can add any number of dense layers, no problem at all. Okay. And then I can say kernel underscore initializer. Okay.
So it means we are having 100 hidden layers?
No. 100 outputs from this hidden layer.
Okay.
Okay. We will be getting 100 outputs from this hidden layer.
Okay. Hidden layer.
Okay. Yeah, and then I can add something like dropout. That is, if you want to add dropout, you can just add like 0.2 or 0.5. Okay, like that. there is probability of dropping out some particular nodes. That's it. Maximum will be one. Okay, so you can drop out 50% of the nodes. Okay, in each and every layer. All right, then I can add the output layer. That is model dot add tens num classes. What is this num classes? We have 10 classes only, right? That is the final output. And for multi-class classification, okay, multi-class classification, the activation function should be softmax. Okay, if it is binary, you should give sigmoid over here. This is the output layer. Okay, so one convolution layer, one pooling layer, then flatten it, then add the hidden layer, then output layer. That's it. Okay, so this is the model. We have just created the model. That's it. We have just created the model. Then we are going to have compile the model. In this compile, we are going to provide a parameter as optimizer. What is the use of optimizer? In order to update
the weights. Yeah.
In order to update the weights after each and every iteration. And then I have to mention loss function. So this is multi-class classification, right? For multi-class classification, the loss function will be sparse, categorical, cross entropy. Okay, all this. If it is multi-class classification, it should be sparse, categorical, cross entropy. And if it is binary classification, you have to use binary underscore cross entropy. Okay, then I have to say matrix. Matrix, you have to give accuracy. That's nothing but accuracy score. So once you compile the model, then fit to the model. Okay, then fit to the model. That is model dot fit x train comma y train. Okay, and then I can give number of iterations. Epochs means number of iterations. And then I can give batch size is equal to 32. And then verbose is equal to 1. Why we are giving this is we need to see the progress. Verbose means it will print the progress of the model. Okay, now you can see it will print. So totally there are 5 iterations. Okay, now you can see now the single iteration is carried out. Okay, so in each and every iteration, 1875 data will be processed. Okay, so basically I can give more number of iterations, but it will take time. See, this one itself is taking a lot of time actually. Okay, see, it is, you can
so
give
is it
in
white training the model now.
Yes, this is what training the model. Yes. Okay, now you can see the accuracy, how it is getting progressed. Okay, see, you can store these results, okay, into some variable, and then you can just use it later on. Okay, that is, you can say history is equal to model dot fit like that, and then you can just say history dot history of loss, history dot history of accuracy. Okay, you can see that is in each and every iteration what is the accuracy like that. Okay, it's taking a lot of time. That The thing is, depends on batch size, the data set has been divided. So basically, I should give more number of iterations. Okay. But due to the time constraint, I'm giving just a less number of iterations actually. See, there are models which runs a week, a month, more than that also. That is just for training. Okay, just for training, it will take more number of times. See, now so far I have got an accuracy of 98% actually. So if you say 60,000, 60,000 by 32, how much it will be? So 1875. Okay, so in each and every iteration, 1875 data set are getting trained. Okay, so this is nothing but fitting the model. Okay, now if I want to evaluate it, I can just write loss comma accuracy is equal to model dot evaluate of x test comma y test comma verbose is equal to 1. Okay, you can see 313 records. Okay, accuracy I'm getting as 98. Now if I want to make a prediction, okay, so I can say image is equal to x underscore train of 0. So we know what is the first images, right? It is 5. Okay, let's see whether it is predicting correct or wrong. Okay, so I can say predictor is equal to model dot predictor of np dot as array of image. Okay, then I can just print predicted. So now if I print predicted, right, it will just, here model dot predict, not subscriptable. Yes, my mistake. Okay, so now you can see it is printing the probability basically. So there are totally 10 classes, right? It is printing the probability. Okay, so now I want to print what is the class. Okay, I want to print what is the class actually. So I can say class hyphen np dot arg max of predicted. That is, what will happen here is it will retrieve the maximum value from this. Okay, and we print the index of that particular element. For example, which is maximum here? This one, right? This is the maximum here, right? So now you can see class is 5. It's printing correct. So it is 5 actually, right? Okay, so now let me just give this one. That is 1. It's nothing but 24, right? This is 0, this is 4, and then this is 24. Correct. Let me give train x of 24. Now you can give class 1. You can see answer is 1. So this is how the image is classified basically. So guys, clear? Guys?
Yeah, mom, clear.
Yeah? Okay. So you want to try now? So have you guys installed it?
The packages are downloaded, but it is taking time to install also. So many packages downloaded.
Oh, okay. Yeah, because it will install so many things, man, actually. TensorFlow.ca. It will also install Keras also. That's
correct, the thing.
Yeah. Okay, so we'll continue the next one. NLP. So guys,
Come on, I'm just trying whatever you have pasted in just a minute.
Yeah. So you just give some two iterations, okay? Don't give five iterations. Just to give two iterations, that should be sufficient. Okay, just for trying purpose, right?
Oops, yeah. Okay.
So I had run one image classification, okay? So by having some photos and all. So it was taking 20 minutes per iteration. So I have given something like, more than 20 minutes, like 30 minutes per iteration actually. So it depends on the complexity of the images also and complexity of the model also. So basically if you add more layer, okay, the complexity of the model is increased. Okay, so that's why I didn't add more layers here. So here you can add more layers, no problem at all. You can add any number of dense layers. Okay. And also like you can have like convolution 2D max pool. Then again, you can do convolution 2D then max pool. But once you do flatten, you should not do this. Okay, so flatten is the end for convolution and pooling. Then the normal deep learning it starts actually. So this is preparing the input basically. Okay, for your model, this is preparing the input. Okay. So guys, clear?
Can you keep this notebook as it is, because you usually clean it up, right? So we will be trying this out later once it is installed.
Yeah. It will not clean up. Everything will be there actually. Even if you shut down, everything will be there. Got it?
The command that you are pasting, right? So usually you clean up, right?
Oh, this one. No. Anyways, we'll be having this one, right? I'll be sharing the notebook itself, no?
Okay.
Yeah, so in that notebook, you can just copy it and then you can run it. No problem.
Sure.
Okay. Yeah. So guys, clear? Ranjit, have you tried?
Yeah, it's running.
It's running, is it? Okay.
Yeah.
So let me know once it is done. So we will see stop words and tokenization in this one. Okay. Susan? Susan?
Hi Mohan, I got disconnected sometime back.
Oh, okay.
It's okay. I think I'll go through that.
Yeah. So we will talk about NLP, okay, in quite some time. And then, Ranjit, is it done?
Second epoch is running. Maybe you can start. It's okay.
Okay. So NLP. So like, what do you mean by NLP, guys? So basically, it is natural language processing. Okay. So the thing is, how do we communicate? So via some languages, right? So like we have to let machine understand about our natural languages. All right. So for example, okay, like let's say there are lots of applications that you can see. Like for example, semantic analysis. Okay, so sorry, sentiment analysis. Okay, it's a very common use case for NLP concepts, right? That is by seeing.
To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the $3.99 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
The review, Okay, so you should be able to classify, that is your machine should be able to classify whether it is a negative review or positive review. Okay, so consider you are writing some review on movies or some products in Amazon. Okay, so by seeing the review itself, that particular machine should be classifying whether it is a bad review or a good review, like that. That's a thing, but sentiment analysis. So that is one of the application of NLP. Okay, and also we can say like we have language translation API. Okay, so depends on the particular sentences that you type in one language be converted to another. And also we can say that information retrieval, that is Google search engine, Yahoo search engine, web search engine. Okay, so you'll be typing only one particular word. Let's say you are typing like a machine. Okay, and depends on your previous searches. Okay, depends on your previous searches, the suggestions will be coming in actually. Okay, so if I type machine, I'll be getting lots of suggestions for machine learning basically. Okay, if I type machine over here, okay, if I type machine over here, see, I'm getting what is the top answer I'm getting? Machine learning MCQs with answers, machine learning, and then machine gun. I never searched actually. Okay, so machine language, machinery, machine learning algorithms like that. So these are all nothing but information retrieval systems, or we can say a web search engine. So this is also works based on NLP concepts. Okay, this is also based on NLP concepts. And you can see like speech recognition. For example, if you go to YouTube and then over there you can search any videos. Okay, you can search any videos over here. All right, but okay. So in this it is not coming, but in mobile it will come. Okay, in mobile you will get for that mic icon will come so that you can pick out and then it will search based on that. Okay, so like that. So that voice recognition system, speech recognition system. So those are all applications of NLP. Okay, so and then we can say we have something called NLPK module. Okay, which will be installed by default. Okay, this particular module is installed by default. Okay, so it's not required to install if you install Anaconda. But there are so many things that you have to install explicitly. That is, for example, let's say nltk.download, that is some utility. Okay, if you execute this particular statement, right, it will just open one another window like this. Like NLTK downloader, something like that. So here you have to select, okay, for example, all corpora. That is, if you say NLTK download of all corpora, if you do that, it will install only this particular stuff. Okay, for example, there is something called stop words, okay, which you are going to talk about. Okay, something called stop words. Okay, something like this over here. Okay, if I want to install this particular stuff, I have to say, okay, this is nothing but ID, identifier. So whatever is mentioned over here, okay, you can just select that and then you can say stop word, something like that. So now this particular corpus will be installed in your system. Then you can retrieve all the stop words from this. So, and then you can upload also, like import also, like nltk.corpus. Import stop words like this. Okay, so what is the purpose of this stop words? For example, consider I'm just importing one more library, the one which we are going to use now. Okay, nltk.tokenize. Okay, import synth_tokenize and then word_tokenize. See, this tokenize is nothing but in order to split the sentence or like paragraph. Okay, if you want to split paragraph to sentences and sentence to words, you have to use this tokenizer. That is splitting one sentence to group of words basically. Nothing else. Okay, nothing a big deal actually over here. So you can try it out over here, right? So now consider I have something called some example sentence. Okay, some, let's say some sample sentence I have. Okay, like let's say sample sentence. Okay, I'm just writing like this is a sample sentence. Okay, showing of the stop words filtration. See, somebody is asking you some question. What is your name? Somebody is asking you. Okay. So depends on the person, like answer, it depends on the person. Okay. So somebody will say, my name is X. Okay. And someone will say, like I am X. Like that. Okay. Somebody will say just X. That's it. Okay. But these three statements conveys the same meaning. That is, the opponent will understand the answer from it. That is, if you say my name is X, or if you say I am X, or if you say just X, all are same. There is no difference in the meaning at all. Okay, but we are using more number of words actually. Okay, so now here we have, okay, here we have something called, this is a sample sentence showing of the stop words filtration like that. Okay, so now what we are going to do is, now we are going to see what do you mean by stop words. Okay, stop words is equal to, I'm just retrieving set of stop words. Okay, I can write stop words dot words of English. So you can provide some language over here actually. Okay, you can provide some language over here. Okay, so and then I can just say stop words. So now these are all something called stop words. So which is not at all required for a sentence. If you remove the stop words from this sentence, it will convey the same meaning. Okay, I am. Okay, I is a stop word. And then am is a stop word. Okay, my name is, my is a stop word if you check it out. Okay, my is a stop word. Okay, yes is a stop word. Even if you remove my name is X, and if you remove my and is, the name, that's, sorry, the meaning will never be changed. Okay, so now what we are going to do is, we are going to tokenize this. So what do you mean by tokens? Okay, that is, this is a sentence basically. Okay, we are going to group it, group this into words. Okay, so I can say tokens, that is word tokens, is equal to word tokenizer of sample sentence. Okay, and then you can see word tokens like this. So we have just retrieved sentence into words now. And then what I am going to do is, we are just remove the stop words from this particular shot. That is, we are going to filter it. Okay, we are going to filter it actually. So for that, let me write some lambda expression. Okay, lambda expression. So I can write check stop words. Okay, I can write lambda word. Okay, I can say word dot lower. Why I am converting to lowercase? Because if you see all the stop words, it is just in lowercase. Just in smaller case letters, not in uppercase letters actually. That's why whatever input that I have, everything I'm just writing in smaller case actually. Okay, word dot lower, not in stop words. Okay, stop words anyways we have it over here. Okay, not in, that is if it is not in that particular stuff, only then it will retrieve true. For example, I am checking like check stop words, okay, of this. Now it has written false, so this will not be retrieved. Okay, now if I say check stop words of sample, this is returning true, so this particular word will be retrieved. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to use filter. Remember yesterday we used a filter, right? So now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to say filter word tokens is equal to okay, list of filter of check stop words, comma word tokens. So now what will happen? Each and every element will be sent as the parameter, okay, to this particular method. And if I print this filtered word tokens, now you can see sample sentence showing stop words filtration. So if I want to join this, okay, I can use the join method actually, okay, that is new sentence is equal to, I can just join using space, okay, dot join, okay, and then I can just write filtered word tokens. So now if I say combined, it's right, okay, or sent sentence, print of sentence, now you can see sample sentence showing stop words filtration. Now what we can do, I can just remove this commas and all, it's not at all required, okay. So for that, I'm just importing RG library, that is regular expression library. Then I am just removing like sentence is equal to re.serf. That is, there is something like slash w, okay. Slash w indicates all non-word characters, that is comma, space, like that. So if anything is fine, just replace with the space. Okay, if anything is fine, just replace with the space. So now you have something like this. So read these two sentence, sample sentence showing stop words filtration. This is a sample sentence showing off the stop words filtration. How about the meaning? How about the meaning, guys? Hello?
It says the same thing.
Yeah, it says the same thing. Right? Mm. So it's a kind of, okay, it's a kind of summarization basically. So like the thing is, we are not taking the entire words actually. So we are just cleaning some particular words from this. So this is the first step in NLP. Like if you go to any things, okay, this is the first step in NLP. So guys, clear? Okay. So
yes.
For example, like if you want to do summarization or if you want to do classification, like based on sentiment analysis. Okay. So what you have to do is you have to download so many things basically. Okay. Like we did it right. NLTK.download. Okay. So over there you can see a number of corpus. Okay. For example, if you want to do, okay, there is something called stemming, okay, stemming and then lemmatization. So these two are very important terms that will be used in NLP. So stemming means, for example, consider there is something, okay, so what do you mean by stemming? Okay, let me just explain that. So what do you mean by stemming? The thing is, stemming means you will be, let's say one particular statement like wait, waiting, and then waited, okay, and then waits, okay, there is something like wait, waiting, waited, waits. So what is the base form of all these words? What is the base form of all these words? It is nothing but wait. Okay. So whenever you stem that particular word, it will just remove, that is, it will just remove the suffix. And then you'll just create some base root form of the word. Okay. But the stemming is not proper basically. For example, if you do stemming on some particular this thing, right, let's say orientation or something like that, okay, or else, okay, so we have something One second. That is, we have some words. Yeah, like for example, if I say giving, okay, let's say giving, gave, gives, okay, and then what else? Given, right? Yeah. So now, if you do stemming on these particular words, it will just give you like this, give. So sometimes it will stem, okay, stem to some meaningless word like this. Okay, so for this particular problem, we will be going for lemmatization. So what it will do is, it will remove the suffix and it will give you the meaningful word. We can select, that is, in which context you can, okay, in which context you have to stem it. Okay, in which context you have to stem it like that. For example, for the same thing, okay, for the same thing, by default, what will happen? This will be changed to give, and this will be changed to give, and this will be changed to give again. Okay, but giving will never be changed, because lemmatization will consider this giving as the proper word. Okay. So for this, what we have to do is, we have to say, like, you have to get a verb out of it. Okay, we have to get some verb out of it. Okay, that is nothing but, so one, that is, if you set the context to verb, right, then it will transfer to give. Okay, so that is the difference between stemming and lemmatization. Okay, stemming, it just blindly removes the suffix. Okay, and just give some words like this, G-I-V, like that. Okay, but lemmatization gives you the proper word, which is like in the dictionary. Okay, so guys, clear? So these are all some techniques in NLP. Okay, guys, so any doubts in this?
I'm good.
Okay, yeah, so that's it from me. So hope you guys enjoyed this training.
Hey, one question, Mohan.
So if
I have two sentences, and does it mean if the same thing? It might be different words I am using. If it is meaning the same thing, how can I do that?
Like,
so it's like so some problem statement, if two people are writing, might be with two different words they are using, synonym words using. So, but at the end, I need to see that whether they said the same thing.
Okay.
So they
are trying to convey the same meaning, but they have used different words.
Yes. So how that summarizing can be done?
So summarizing. Okay, see, this summarizing, we have something like, we have to find the weight of each and every word. Okay, sorry, weight of each and every sentence. That is
okay.
The thing is, consider, first we need to find the number of occurrences of the words. Okay, and then we need to find the maximum occurrence, like we need to find the word which has maximum occurrence. Okay, then what we have to do is, then we have to find the weighted frequency. Okay, and then now for each and every word, there will be some frequency, right? So we need to sum all the weights. For example, in sentence, let's say, keep working, keep going, like that. Okay, keep working, keep going, something like that. Okay, so these are two different sentences. All right, so we have to find the weight for each and every sentence based on the weights of each and every word. Okay,
okay,
and then we have to just retrieve the top n weights, so top n sentences which has the maximum weight. Okay, so if you do that, then we can easily summarize it. Okay, if you do that, right, we can easily summarize it actually. So first we need to find the weights of each and every word in the entire context, and then we have to find the weight of each and every sentence. Okay, and then we have to decide which sentence has the maximum weight. Then we have to retrieve the top n sentences which has the maximum weight. So that is the way to find.
So for my question is like, the system is down, the system failed. If the my sentence is like that, so does that both the sentence means the same thing? Okay, so with that weight, if it is coming together, means there's those sentences.
It is same thing. It is same thing actually. Yeah, it is same thing. Because system, you are using system twice, so system will be having maximum weight actually. Okay, down and system is failed, so you are using only one, so we'll be having the same weight. So both the sentences will be having the same weight, because yes and like the weights will not be calculated for stop words.
So but in that case, how the meaning factor part is coming in that case?
No. The thing is, weights will never be calculated for stop words, but while summarizing, all the words will be considered. Got it? So weights will be added. See, for example, consider I have something like this, okay? Consider I have something like this, okay? Like I am, okay, going to drive, something like this. Okay, so here weights will be calculated only for non-stop words, that is going and then drive.
Yeah, that is the n-gram technique we'll be using for finding the weight.
Yes, exactly. Okay, and then now what we have to do is, while summing the, that is while finding the weight of the sentence, you have to just consider only the non-stop words. That is, consider the weight for this is 0.25 and for this is 0.25 like that, or 0.35, something like that. Okay, and the weights of these sentences, for this the weight is 0, I am 2, because it is not at all found. Okay, so now the weight for this sentence is 0.60. Okay, so based on this particular weight, we have to do that actually.
Please enroll our general membership for $399 plan to get access of all the parts.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click on to the join button, select the $399 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.